Hey, this is Pat Cox. Welcome back to round one of a Shadows of Innistrad Draft here on Channel Fireball. So we're on the play. I guess this is a keep. Having turn two Bloodsworn is pretty great, but not being able to cast these till potentially turn five, have no discard outlets yet, less great. I think we'll keep. I mean, if we hit one land, we're going to go, 2-1 into 3-2 is pretty nice. If we draw lands every turn, then we'll just very easily win. So, just hope we do that. Alright. Got there. Ish. Just need two more of those, and then preferably no more. Maybe like one more so I can give the second twins haste. Thing in the ice, okay. It's a card that I'm not really clear on how high you're supposed to pick it, so. Don't really mind that my opponent has it. Like, even if I lose to it, that's good info for the Pro Tour. Blue-red, like, pretty much all spells is a deck in this format, so it is something you're going to want in that deck. My question is more, how high do I pick it, because it really only goes in that deck. And here we see why Rush is less exciting, because, we have this 3-2, and I have a 3-2, and I can't really effectively attack into it. Like, I can still attack, because maybe he'll block this thing in ice, and maybe that's worth doing. I guess it also kind of clears the way for my Blood Mad Vampire. Yeah, I'll probably just attack. It's a little annoying because he gets to draw a card, so it's not like a free attack. I don't mind trading, but trading and they draw a card is not the most exciting thing for me. But blocks a thing that I can rush. Blocks with this guy, then maybe my Blood Mad can get in next turn. Okay. So I guess that was a decent draw. I would rather probably have just drawn a land, but beggars can't be choosers and such. Please just be sacrificing this clue. Oh man. It's actually not that bad for me, but. Question being, does this sacrifice any creature? So I can do it on itself. So do I want to attack leaving this potential trick up, or just attack with this on the table? But then I get a permanent boost to my guys. That's probably better. Like, I kind of just want this to get through. Of course, my opponent might just have not blocked anyway, because a scarecrow is really important to their plan or something. I have no clue. Definitely, in drafts with my friends and stuff, I have games where I kill their Scarecrow, and they're like, "Man, that was key. I needed that card." All right. So I guess the only thing that mana could have represented would be the one damage to two different things, which would actually have been pretty insane there, I guess, but probably could have just done it in response to my guy. Alright, so he sacrificed a clue. That's good. That's what I want him to be doing on a turn. So I guess just Stormkirk. Probably on my flyer. Well, Thing has not looked very good this game, but my opponent also has 5 cards in hand, so presumably it spells at some point. Could have like a Just the Wind here or something. Unless they play 4 spells next turn, I don't really foresee them winning the game. Yeah, I mean, just dead on board. Just me attacking with everything makes you dead. Yep, okay. So we're Rug. I don't even really know what all is going on in this deck, but... could side in Kindly Stranger to kill Thing and Ice? I don't think I care that much. I feel like more what we might want because of Thing and Ice is like Grotesque Mutation type cards. Like maybe that's better than messing around with Sanitarium Skeleton. Getting cute. So, I mean, while that is good against Thing and Ice, is it really good against other cards in the deck? I mean, not really. I had the same issue. It has the same issue as Rush of Adrenaline. I guess we'll stay with this. The issue being, like, oh, they play Byway Courier or whatever, and I'm like, okay, well, great. I can't attack my 3-2 into your 3-2 even though I have a combat trick. It's a similar hand to last time, except I don't... Well, it's actually the same thing. I still have Starwood Mana either way. Yeah, I'm going to keep. I mean, I have 8 mountains and 3 chances to draw them. Well, maybe I want that card now. If he has multiple O4s, that might be blocking me. Alright, well, drew my Sanitarium Skeleton right on time. Yeah, maybe I'm just getting too cute with this card. It's, like, pretty terrible in play, just in general. So, I mean, it is a repeatable blocker, I guess, but, really want to be doing a bunch of discarding if you're playing this card. I feel like my opponent really didn't need to go through combat there. If they're not going to attack, I'm tapped out. Might as well just play your spells in F6. Alright. I just straight up can't block. It's not like can't block creatures with flying. So, guess we'll attack... I guess we'll play the skeletons. It's not the most exciting proposition, but does block his Loam Dryad. we somehow got Delirium next turn, it blocks the Scavenger, but that would be pretty lucky. That would be basically just, like, Green Vessel. Alright, so how does this flip? The same thing as Delver. I would... Well, my initial assumption would be that they have a lot of instants and sorceries, so they have Thing and Ice and this card, but I've seen, like, quite a few creatures, so maybe they don't. Alright, that's good. That's good. That's what we're looking for. I did keep the hand, but I think it was right too. I had my best 2-drop and, you know, plenty of mountains in the deck. I would guess I probably have about one more turn to draw out of this. I guess they're not really doing anything, so maybe I have more, but... Well, at least they milled a Pack Guardian. Got that going for us. The card is busted. And I passed 2 of it. So, just based on 0 spells I've been cast so far, I can't actually imagine thinking the ice is good in this deck. Alright, well, that buys time. I think it's still that over Duskwatch Recruiter, despite Duskwatch Recruiter being very good. That turns into a 5/4. I don't have many ways to kill it, so. Alright. It's like, do I want to take 2, but then I have to pay to get this back, but it's not. Whatever. I think I'll have 1 mana extra to play this next turn, so seems fun. I feel like I'm pretty much getting to the point where if I draw a red mana, I have to just like jam Spiteful Motives on my guy. Because I'm like gonna be too far behind to try and win otherwise. Well, whatever's happening, I don't like it. Aim high? Ugh. Can't win. Oh man, there's no way I can win. Also, aim high is just busted against my deck, and I can't like sideboard around that. Really, I mean, it's too many cards. Okay, that's cool. Not really coming back there. I do think I want this Grotesque Mutation, though. I'd probably just get rid of the stupid skeleton. Yeah, I mean, if they have 3 O4s in their deck, then that card just becomes good. I would like to play first. I mean, this seems like a good hand. I got a mix of red and black mana, so... And Olivia on turn 3. Like, my opponent's deck doesn't seem to have any ways that I've seen so far to deal with Flyer besides block it, so could be tempting just to jam this on my Olivia, then just like kill them with my Uncaged Fury. If only Deadweight was Disfigure. That was an instant, right? I think so. Kind of annoying not to get to use my mana. I certainly want to kill that stupid guy, but not as much as I want to play this Olivia. I feel like I'd rather flip my werewolf than play that thing, Jesus. Well, here I was considering, like, man, if I play my Stormkirk, should I give it haste, all this, but nah, I just didn't draw land. So, I guess I'm just gonna deadweight this guy. Not the worst use of a turn. Can get kind of out of control. Though, being able to, like, attack with my Stormkirk into a 2-2, so I just am guaranteed to deal 4 would be pretty nice. Alright. Yeah, I guess the question is, do I want to give Stormkirk haste, and then it trades? I mean, trading with his researcher certainly isn't horrible or anything. Though I'm going to be down a card. I don't know if the game's going to be that fast. I also don't really know what if I'm gonna need this Mad Prophet this game. Nah, I don't think I wanna. Alright. Though I guess he also could just have like that stupid boar next turn or flip researcher or whatever. Yeah, I guess hold. Alright. I guess another option would be to do that, but not actually attack with it. And then I could play the other Stormkirk next turn. And then it would be bigger than a 3-2. Inner Struggle is like terrible against his board, so it's an easy decision this turn. Alright, we did it. We drew our rare. Alright, I will see you guys for round 2.